saw the president allow the places of worship to open, but with a number of 200 Christians. In PIG Church here, located in Sorority City East in Ajib Ward. The turnup has been big, but the church has been able to control and of course see that there has been social distancing in a way that they have different masses. Before a Christian enters the church, he or she has to wash his or her hands. The temperature should be checked and recorded down in a document provided. Inside the church is sprayed after every service. The chairs are clean using different sanitizers before the Christians enter inside the church. Different churches have also been observing the same.
Today we started well, much as the number was big, but we were able to follow the directives of the president and 200 people to attend the service. For me as a pastor, and not only me, as a team, we really want to appreciate the directives of the president, also of giving us 200 people to attend the service. And we were able to manage it very well. We handled it very well as a team of PAG Sorority. We allowed the people to obey the SOPs, and they were able to willing, and they were able to follow. Because as a pastor, my responsibility is to give direction to the church. And I think all people who came were able to rejoice, because there was also social distancing and also the facilities for washing our hands we also put in place. And when you see around, you discover that we have about 5 facilities that we have installed in the compound where people go and wash their hands. We also have temperature guns, 2 of them, and we did not allow anyone to enter into the service without taking his temperature. So then also we have some forms, registration forms, where we register their names, their contacts, and also we capture what we want to capture from them. So I think today being a first day, it was a bit hectic, but we were able to be obedient to the directives of the president.
Okay, Pastor, you asked the man of God about the COVID-19 vaccination. There have been rumors spreading around the public, scaring the people that this vaccination is connected with the devil. What can you say about that?
You know, people have different perception and imagination, especially people who have been manipulated by the false prophets. Mm. They have believed that the vaccine is a part of 66. But me as a pastor, I don't have any problem with the vaccine that the government has brought to help people prevent them from coronavirus. So which I believe that soon we shall begin helping our Christians and encouraging them to have, to be vaccinated. So the issue of the vaccine being brought into the life of people as a sign that will attract demons to their lives, I don't understand, but also I don't believe that, because I don't think the government can bring demons from all over the world to affect or to destroy the citizens of Uganda. So I want to be clear that as a pastor, there is nothing wrong with the vaccine, except that people need to be guided, people need to be directed, but also needs to be told. And that's my responsibility. I believe from next Sunday onwards, I will begin speaking about the vaccine, so that they will vaccinate themselves as children of God.
From the look of things here in St. Paul Church, a church that is actually under Church of Uganda here in Morapeso, in Sorati City East, the SOPs are well observed. Before you enter in, you have to wash your hands. And of course, before you enter inside the church, they have to check your body temperature. Inside the church, there is a social distancing. Every Christian is actually on a mask. I can bring to you that SOPs are well observed. First Sunday from the time the president officially opened the places of worship, but of course giving one regulation that only 200 people should be allowed in the place of worship. This church has about 3 different masses every Sunday. The first mass has actually a big number of people, and right now inside has been the second mass.
The message to the Christians out there is that we need to follow the SOPs. That is one thing, because it is the desire of the church to see that Christians are healthy, because we don't want to lose any of them. That is what we are preaching for. Then the second thing is that as a church, we have to push on and tell the Christians and all people to go for vaccination and to observe the SOPs, so that we shall remain as people of this world, the people of this country, and the people of God.
Nathan Eyagu reporting from Sorati City East.